All the big updates that have come in the last 24 hours in the Malival assault controversy. The investigation now going full steam ahead by the Delhi police. Bibhav Kumar, Kejriwal's aide, who was arrested just a few days ago, has now been taken to Mumbai because the police have all along suspected that he formatted his phone in Mumbai. Remember that they've not been able to gather any evidence from his phone. Bibhav, on his part, has maintained that his phone was constantly hanging and that's why he decided to delete all the data. But they're looking to retrieve that, which is why they've taken him now to Mumbai. This, even as the political war of words continues, the Aam Aadmi Party lashing out at Malival, repeating their taunt that she's a BJP agent. Let's get you a roundup of all the details first.
Investigation into the alleged assault on AAP MP Swati Malival gains momentum. A police team has taken Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal's aide and accused Bibhav Kumar to Mumbai. The investigators want to retrieve data from his formatted iPhone. They suspect that Bibhav Kumar may have destroyed crucial evidence on his phone while he was in Mumbai. On Monday, the police took Bibhav to the Chief Minister's residence to recreate the crime scene. He was arrested on Saturday from Kejriwal's residence 2 days after a case was registered against him for allegedly beating up Malival. According to sources, the police have so far found no footage of the assault. Sources say the CCTV footage submitted by the Chief Minister's office has gaps in it. Malival's charges of physical assault by Kejriwal's most trusted aide have ignited a political firestorm.
Kejriwal ji root jayenge. कि भाई निजी आरोप करते हैं मगर भाइयों बहनों मुझे बताओ मुख्यमंत्री आवास में किसी राज्यसभा सांसद महिला का पिटाई हो वो दिल्ली की महिलाओं को सुरक्षित रख सकते हैं क्या?
The app is on the back foot.
स्वाति मालीवाल जी की वीडियो फुटेज पूरे देश के सामने आ गई. पूरे देश ने देख लिया कि जो स्वाति मालीवाल ने अपने एफआईआर में लिखा था वो सरासर झूठ था. उस वीडियो फुटेज से स्वाति मालीवाल जी और भारतीय जनता पार्टी के षड्यंत्र का पर्दाफाश हो गया.
मालीवाल हैज क्लेम्ड दैट दिल्ली मिनिस्टर्स आर स्प्रेडिंग लाइज बाय कॉलिंग हर अ बीजेपी एजेंट. शी एलिजेस दैट एवरीवन इन द पार्टी इज बीइंग आस्क्ड टू लीक हर पर्सनल वीडियोस.
दिल्ली पुलिस हैज रिकॉर्डेड द स्टेटमेंट्स ऑफ ऑल द स्टाफ present in the CM's residence on the 13th of May. It is a very crucial part of the investigation because based on this, when Bibhav Kumar's custody expires on Thursday, Delhi police will or will not seek further remand of Bibhav Kumar, and that will entirely depend on what they find in Mumbai in this course of investigation. With video journalist Ashwini Helen, this is Shreya Chatterjee for India Today.
So now the investigative action moving to Mumbai from Delhi. The Delhi police team, as we speak, is taking Bibhav Kumar to Mumbai. I want to bring in Divyesh Singh, who's tracking all the updates now from Mumbai, joining us live on this broadcast. Divyesh, good evening. Any details that we've been able to really pick up on where Bibhav will be taken to Mumbai? Because the suspicion is that when he was in Mumbai after Delhi, after this reported assault took place, he then went ahead and formatted his phone in the city.
Well, Akshita, as you pointed out, Bibhav Kumar was in Mumbai after the assault on Swati Malival. And that is when it is suspected that he formatted his phone. He has removed, cleared all the data from his iPhone while he was in Mumbai. So there are various agencies working, which retrieve data from the phone or also format phones in Mumbai. That is where Bibhav Kumar will be taken by the Delhi police. As of now, it is not yet known which particular agency had helped Bibhav Kumar. His plane just landed a while ago in Mumbai, and any moment he'll be brought out from the arrival gates at the Mumbai airport. But as of now, Mumbai police team is also there to escort the Delhi police team to the location where Bibhav Kumar is to be taken.
All right, Divyesh, we'll keep tracking those updates with you and come across to you the moment Bibhav Kumar is brought out of the airport. Divyesh also telling us that the team of the Mumbai police is also there to accompany the Delhi police there. Thanks very much for those details. Let's cut across to breaking news coming in on the investigation. Now, as part of the probe, the Delhi police is also recording the statement of all of the staff present at the Chief Minister's residence who witnessed the alleged assault as it took place on May 13th. This is, of course, procedural protocol for all witnesses' statements to be recorded. But perhaps this will give more details of exactly what happened, considering that there are blank parts of the CCTV footage where essentially the Delhi police have to fill in the blanks. And they will be counting on witness statements to actually do that. Shreya Chatterjee is joining us live with all the details. She's been tracking this investigation from day one. Shreya, a lot of the statements of witnesses being recorded right now, largely these will also be members of the Delhi police who are there as security.
Well, absolutely, Akshita, you very rightly pointed it out, because remember one of those 51-second videos that were leaked, we saw all of those three officials who were present were actually Delhi police officials who are on CM duty. But not just Delhi police officials, the CM security regular staff, all their statements have been recorded. That protocol is already completed. The reason that it's required is to verify and corroborate the statements that also Vibhav Kumar and Swati Maliwal has given, and that this will be substantiated with digital evidence in the form of CCTV footage. This is on Thursday. Vibhav Kumar's custody expires with the Delhi police, and based on what they have found in the 5 days, they might seek more custody of Vibhav Kumar, and there's a possibility of invoking a fresh section, because there's already the mentioning of missing CCTV footage by the Delhi police in the court of law. So in all likelihood, you will also be seeing them invoking section 201, which is destruction of evidence.
Okay. Okay, Shreya, I'm going to request you to stay with me. We're going to need your inputs later in this broadcast as well as we focus on the story. But let's put the focus now on what Swati Maliwal has said. While she hasn't really spoken to the media, she's been constantly putting out statements on social media to counter the ARP's narrative that she's a BJP agent. And here's what Maliwal has said now. She slammed the Aam Aadmi Party for the stand, saying, until I was on their side, I was referred to as Lady Singham. And today, now that I've complained against Vibhav, they're calling me a BJP agent. That's not all. She's also alleging that now her relatives are being harassed, her close friends, aides are all being harassed to leak private personal videos of her. This is a grave allegation that Swati Maliwal has leveled, thereby upping the ante against the Aam Aadmi Party in this really ugly war of words between her party and Maliwal herself. Let's get your breaking news coming in. Some support also pouring in for Swati Maliwal. And the Delhi Lieutenant Governor has issued a statement on the assault case playing out in the national capital. Swati Maliwal has met with him, and soon after that, he lashed out at the Aam Aadmi Party, saying Kejriwal is evasive and dodgy. These are the words the Lieutenant Governor has used. He said Kejriwal is evasive and dodgy on the issue of the assault case filed by Swati Maliwal. And the Lieutenant Governor has also said that Chief Minister Kejriwal should come clean, and his silence as of now reveals exactly what his stance is on women's safety. So in the back and forth between the Delhi government and the LG, which nobody is new to really in the national capital, you're now seeing the Lieutenant Governor siding with Swati Maliwal, saying very clearly that Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal must break his silence, and that the onus is on him directly because he's being evasive and dodgy, as the Lieutenant Governor puts it. Let's get you now ARP's reaction to the LG's letter. And the Aam Aadmi Party also rebutting the Lieutenant Governor right now, saying very clearly that the LG's letter only proves our point, only proves that, yes, Swati Maliwal is working for the BJP. Now, according to the Aam Aadmi Party, there is the BJP coming up with one conspiracy after another in the elections, liquor scams, Swati Maliwal, false allegations of foreign funding. All of this, according to ARP, is a conspiracy by BJP against Arvind Kejriwal. And also now lashing out at the Lieutenant Governor, saying that now that he's spoken out on Maliwal, it's very, very clear that all of this is a political conspiracy. Let's bring in Shreya once again on this broadcast. Shreya, layers of political fight that we're witnessing. On one hand, AAP versus BJP. On the other, you have within the Aam Aadmi Party this massive storm because of Swati Maliwal being a part of the political outfit, also lashing out at the party. The AAP calling their own Rajya Sabha MP as a BJP agent. And now the Lieutenant Governor also wading into this entire fight and saying very clearly that Kejriwal is being evasive. So the Aam Aadmi Party is putting out all of these political fires, and which is days to go for the elections in the national capital. Remember that Delhi votes on May 25th. So those are the big updates that are coming in on this story. We've told you about the big political fight. We've given you the details on the investigation. As we continue to track this very, very closely, let's also get you more breaking news that's coming in, quickly shifting focus to this big, big news break. All right, let's get you now breaking news coming in from Singapore Airlines making an emergency landing in Bangkok after the flight was hit by a bout of severe turbulence. How bad was it? The images are on your screen, speaks volumes, really. One passenger on board has even died, dozens of them injured. We advise viewer discretion as some of these pictures are extremely graphic in nature, as several passengers, you can see there, suffered nosebleeds. Some of them got injured because they weren't really wearing their seatbelts. The turbulence, we understand, hit the aircraft suddenly, leading to crew members, passengers all getting injured. One passenger has also died because of severe turbulence. You don't hear of this too often. It tells you really how bad the situation was. The flight has now made an emergency landing in Bangkok, is what we hear. Now, this was a flight that was headed, in fact, from London. It was a Boeing 777-300ER plane with 211 passengers, 18 crew, was headed from London to Singapore, is now in Bangkok. There is emergency medical care being provided to the passengers who've been injured on board. Horrifying images, really. One passenger even dying as a result of severe turbulence. A reminder, perhaps, for all of us that when we're in the aircraft, as much as possible, stay strapped in, wear that seatbelt. Now, that's all we have time for on this broadcast. That important news break is something we will track very, very closely. I'm wrapping up this episode of Election Express from Patna. Remember to watch out for our ground report coming in just 2 days from now on Thursday. Till then, thanks for tuning in.